Let's begin with the District A race. District A includes parts of Uptown, Carrollton, and Lakeview. And that's where WDSU reporter Travers Mackel is live right now, beginning our Commitment 2010 coverage. Travers?
Hey, Camille, it seems that history repeats itself in the District A City Council race. This is the fourth time that J-Bat has run for this seat. In the previous three, things have gotten ugly. Attack ads have flown, and it has been a nasty, nasty race. And this year, no different, as J-Bat squares off against Democrat Susan Guidry. Now, within the last hour, we caught up with both candidates. Here is video of J-Bat and his supporters in Lakeview at Carroll Canal and Harrison, out waving signs, asking people for support. We caught up with Susan Guidry in Holly Grove. She was out there trying to get support. But like I mentioned, this race has gotten ugly. We've seen that dancing bat ad. Bat has also sent out flyers with pictures of Susan Guidry trying to take away from her campaign. So we asked both candidates, why is it that in the last decade, whoever runs for Council District A, things always get heated?
Oh, I don't know historically why that might be. I know in this situation, what we have is that my opponent has been spreading lies about me, about the people who are supporting me. I think it's truly despicable. When you want to talk against another candidate, you should be using the facts.
I wish it wasn't played like that. And, you know, being the recipient of some of those attack ads, my family would appreciate it, too, if it was changed a bit.
Now, here's something very interesting. In 2002, J-Bat ran a very ugly race, or got into a very ugly race, with Scott Shea. Scott Shea, this time around, who's a former councilman, is supporting J-Bat. And check out this video. A couple of hours ago, members of the Park and Parksway Commission came out and took down those Anyone But Bat signs. According to the people who put those signs up, they had to be taken down because they didn't support a specific candidate, either J-Bat or Susan Guidry, and they didn't support a constitutional amendment. So according to the people who put up those Anyone But Bat signs all along District A, they had to come down. That is the very latest from Lakeview and the District A race.